Welcome once again. Right now we're at Acts chapter 25, verses 1 through 12. Paul's trial before Festus. Festus, therefore, having come into the province, after 3 days went up to Jerusalem from Caesarea. Then the high priest and the principal men of the Jews informed him against Paul, and they begged him, asking a favor against him, that he would summon him to Jerusalem, plotting to kill him on the way. However, Festus answered that Paul should be kept in custody at Caesarea, and that he himself was about to depart shortly. Let them, therefore, he said, that are in power among you go down with me, and if there is anything wrong in the man, let them accuse him. When he had stayed among them more than 10 days, he went down to Caesarea, and on the next day he sat on the judgment seat, and commanded Paul to be brought. When he had come, the Jews who had come down from Jerusalem stood around him, bringing against him many and grievous charges, which they could not prove. While he said in his defense, neither against the law of the Jews, nor against the temple, nor against Caesar have I sinned at all. This is remarkable. As I've said before, Philippians chapter 3, we've got Paul's own writings that said, according to the law, according to the Torah, I am blameless. How many people who confess to be Christians can actually say that? According to the Torah, I live up to it all. You know, and indeed it is easy to live up to if you really know what the Torah is and what you are supposed to live up to. You know, Deuteronomy chapter 30, God made it very clear at the end of the Torah, you know, the commandments that I gave to you are not too hard for you to obey. You know, he's not a tyrant that he goes around, an unreasonable ruler that he goes around and just barks out commands to people that he knows cannot fulfill those commands. God doesn't do that. God gives us commands, and his commandments, as John said, are not grievous. They're not burdensome, okay? So Paul here, he made it very clear. He hasn't sinned against Torah at all. Now that goes against, you know, some of the foundational evangelical Christian teachings that says that nobody can obey Torah. Paul certainly said that he did blamelessly in Philippians chapter 3, several times here in the book of Acts as well. And this is one time where he obviously and clearly said, I have not sinned against the law. Also notice that false witnesses are the hallmark of God-haters. Many false witnesses against the prophets, false witnesses against Jesus, and here we have false witnesses against Paul. And if you go out there and you preach righteousness, if you preach against the sin of the people, you're going to have false witnesses rise up against you as well. So Paul said here in his defense, neither against the law of the Jews, nor against the temple, nor against Caesar have I sinned at all. But Festus, desiring to gain favor with the Jews, answered Paul and said, are you willing to go up to Jerusalem and be judged by me concerning these things? And Paul said, I am standing before Caesar's judgment seat where I ought to be tried. I have done no wrong to the Jews, as you also know very well. Notice Paul here is speaking very straight, very direct, very strong to the authorities here. For if I have done wrong and have committed anything worthy of death, I don't refuse to die. But if none of those things is true that they accuse me of, no one can give me up to them. I appeal to Caesar. Then Festus, when he had conferred with the council, answered, you have appealed to Caesar. To Caesar you shall go. Notice that Paul is not wimpy here, okay? You know, he is no pansy here. He puts up a fight. And you know, a lot of times God wants us to fight, you know, fight in his name, okay? There are times to fight and there are times to turn the other cheek. And I pray that God would give us the wisdom to know the difference. Seek him and you will find him if you seek him with all your heart. Call upon him and he will show you great and mighty things. Love you guys.